Time, but this time we're gonna sing it soft and then loud and soft again and then maybe loud again, but you never know. Here we go.
My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
And girls, and hello to all you parents out there as well. It's time for another round of Chapel Time. I'm Pastor Jelani, and I'm here to read you guys a story. And, what's that? Why are there stripes around my face and on my body? Oh, that's because I'm in my office and the sun is shining in, and the blinds are making kind of a cool design. Let me see what happens if I pull these up. Yeah, there we go. Oh, but now the sun is way too bright. Tell you what, let's take this to camera too. So, today we're gonna have a story because that's what we do at Chapel Time. It's now the month of April, and in the month of April, we are gonna be talking about one of the fruit of the Spirit called faithfulness. We're gonna talk about what does it mean to be faithful? And, is God faithful? Can we be faithful? These are really important questions. And so in order to get at that, I'm going to read you guys a story. And this is taken from a book, Moms and Dads, if you are interested. This is taken from a book called Read Along Bible Stories. This is volume 4. And the story we're going to read today is called Joshua and the Big Wall. Okay. Let's see if I can hold this upright as we do this. This is an adventure for me too. Oh, I can't read this because the type looks backward on my camera. We're gonna have to try this again. This is Joshua and the Big Wall. Oh, there we go. Joshua was a man, and God told Joshua what to do. Then Joshua told God's people. "
Jericho was a place. Jericho had houses in it. Jericho had a big wall all around it. See that big wall? That's a big wall, isn't it? Yeah. The big wall had a door. Every day, the Jericho people went in and out, in and out of their door. See all the people there? Yeah, they're going in and out of the door. Now, God wanted his people inside Jericho, but the Jericho people said no. The Jericho people shut their door tight. See that? That's the Jericho people shutting their door. I bet it made a big sound like this. I don't really know if that's what it sounded like, but that's how I imagine it. And their wall was so big that it kept everybody out. That's a big wall. God knew what to do. God told Joshua, and Joshua told God's people, horn blowers, line up. Soldiers, line up. He said, don't talk until I tell you, but horn blowers, you get ready to blow your horns. Then away went the soldiers, then away went the horn blowers, step, step, step on their way to Jericho. That's a lot of people. Look at that. Everybody walked. Nobody talked. But the horn blowers blew their horns. They marched all the way around Jericho's big wall. Step, 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 step. And then they went home. The next day, they marched around again. Step, step, step. Everybody walked, nobody talked, but the horn blowers blew their horns. See all those horn blowers? There's a lot of them. And they blew their horns. I bet it sounded really loud. The next day, guess what? They went again. And the next day, and the next, around and around, step, 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 step. Everybody walked, nobody talked, but the horn blowers blew their horns. Wow, I bet it was hard to do all that walking and not talk. And then Joshua said, now. And when Joshua said, now, the horn blowers blew, the horn blowers blew, the soldiers shouted, and Jericho's big wall fell down. Crash, bang. God did it. And God's people walked right into Jericho. They didn't even need the door. Well, what did we learn from this story? We learned that Joshua obeyed. He did what God said. And God's people obeyed. They did what Joshua said. Now, my question for you is, who should you obey? Is there anyone else that you should obey?
You know, boys and girls, as I said before, this story is about faithfulness. If you don't know what faithfulness means you keep doing the right thing, even when it gets hard or even when it takes a long time. And in this story, the people did a lot of walking and the horn blowers did a lot of blowing their horns. And for a while, it didn't seem like anything was going to happen. But then, after a long time, God showed that he was still with them and they were able to have a victory because they remained faithful. That's what it means to be faithful or to have faithfulness, is to keep going at doing the right thing, even when it takes a long time or when it gets hard. And, you know, I bet there are things that you and I have to do when we're at home, especially right now. A lot of us have to stay home for a long time, and I bet that seems really hard. But I believe God will continue to be with us, and God loves it when we stay faithful to what we're supposed to do. As a matter of fact, that reminds me of a song. So parents, before I get into this song that I'm playing and I want to share with you, there's also several scriptures that you might want to look up in the Bible that talk about God's faithfulness and talk about what it means for us to be faithful. So I encourage you, parents, when you're done watching this video and you have some time, just go ahead and check some of these scriptures out. But they are in the New Testament, the book of Luke, Luke chapter 16, verses 10 through 12, Proverbs chapter 3, verse 3, and in the Old Testament, the book of Jeremiah 29, verse 13. I'm going to play for a few more moments while you write those down, and then I'll show you the song. Like this. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness to me. When I look at my life, all that I see is your faithfulness to me. Great is your faithfulness. Great your faithfulness to me. When I look at my life, all that I see is your faithfulness to me. You want to try that with me? Let's sing that together. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness to me. Boys and girls, our time together is almost over. But as we do with every chapel time, I'm going to take a moment to pray, which means I'm just going to talk to God, and I'm going to ask God to help us. So if you would like to pray with me, you can put your hands together like this and just close your eyes, and I will pray for us. Dear Lord, thank you for your presence here. Thank you for the sunshine. Thank you for keeping us safe in our homes. Thank you for those of us who are healthy right now, that you're keeping us healthy. And for those who are sick right now, God, be with them and please help them to get better. God, I also pray that you would help us to be faithful. Help us to keep doing the right thing, even when it's hard, even when it feels like, it should be over by now. But Lord, you are faithful to us, and so help us to be faithful to you and to each other. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's children say, amen. Well, one more song we have to sing. That's a song we sing for every chapel service. And I think you know it, so if you do, sing along with me.